And welcome back to my dear shack. It's very nice in here. Kinda like the song though. We're out here. Alright, so when I last left you, we had escaped that lumberyard over there. And now we're on the search for collectibles. Maybe. I feel like there should be a collectible around here. Oh, mercifully, yep. This one over here. Not very much collectible, but you know, supply crate. And if you keep an eye out, you know, you're not gonna run out of much of anything in this game, as I said before. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. It's probably a good thing because in this game, you know, you don't have any other options when you run out of ammo. It's just kind of then it's like, flee for your lives! Which is kind of disappointing.
At first I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
Hey, we don't know if Alice needs saving. Sorry, sweetie, you're the one who fucked up and drove out in a hissy fit. I kind of swore, though, that somewhere around here, I saw a shiny. Maybe I didn't. I'm just freaking crazy! Oh, right, it's the cans. I just got the cans. Oh well. Well, back on our adventure, happy time, people. How have you all been doing? I've been enjoying a nice, relaxing evening with Alan Wake. I can use some Bioshock. Wait, what's that? There it is. I spy shiny.
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Ooh.
The best forms in the street. Belly Burster is the best with no curves. Monster Dog is second best.
Uh-oh.
Famous Dog is...
Sounds like he's talking about a race. Okay. I keep hoping that the... Oh, we're in this area. This area is technically... not a happy place, so we're gonna... Alright. Suck on that. If I remember correctly, this is actually one of those infinite responding areas. Uh-oh, one sec. Sorry, I didn't want to sneeze all over the mic and destroy your ears. Oh, uh-oh. Oh, not cool, bro. Now, see, I have to admit that in, the newer... Oh, what's that? Safe Haven. Oh, huh. In the newer Alan Wake, you know, American Nightmare... I could have sworn that there's another copy that was somewhere. But, the newer Alan Wake, what was I going to say? Right. Safe Havens are no longer, like, you know... this super awesome where if you go in it all the enemies suddenly disappear. It's more along the lines that I swear there's supposed to be like an item in here somewhere. I mean, I really regret doing this, but I want to do it. Oh dear. That's a lot of guys. That's like three. Oh, what a dick. You guys, quit it. Sorry, I took a little concentration there. Well, there's that, but I swear... What does it say? Safe Haven. Oh, I was talking about that. I swear there's supposed to be another... Oh, there it is! I see it! Oh no, now there's people everywhere. Ow! What a dick. Oh, Double dodge. Oh, right, not off the cliff. That would be a bad idea. All right, problem solved. Right, people? Right. There it is. My beautiful coffee. It's so worth it. You know, next to health, you know, coffee's godliness. Actually, wait, isn't it next to health? Oh, no. Run! Actually, let's just pick this up.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
Oh dear. Where are you guys at? There's one, there's two. Alright, I think we can make it up now. A little bit of a fun tactic is just to shine a light on them, just to slow them down, and then just get into a safe haven. They all go away. I can hear him still. Oh, Alan's still. Oh, right, Alan's bleeding from the concussion earlier. I keep on thinking, it's like, oh man, is his health really still low? But nah, he's fine. He's fine, brah. Now, if I remember correctly. There we go. I think this is the last one for the area. Let's go this way. And right there, there it is. How convenient all these are right along the path I was going to take. Ooh, we got some breathing going on. Alright. Uh-oh. You fool, you need salad. Salad makes everyone happy. Everyone requires some amount of salad in their life. Oh, oh no. The party pooper parade has shown up. That's good. I don't. I enjoy being inside this house right here. This is a very nice house. I like it a lot. Ooh, TV time.
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Quantum Suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die? Yes, yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here. You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality! Poor, poor Dr. Colvin. Filled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat in night sprains.
So yeah, that's there's a little thing that goes on during this. This is another collectible in the game. There's a lot of collectibles in this game where you can watch TV shows of Night Springs or other TV shows that show up every once in a while. And I think there's 9 of those. I don't know, but hey, we got shotgun ammo and lithium batteries can't pick up because I'm full on batteries again. All right. Oh, we got this press button. All right. Oh, look, they're all gone. Poor guys. They never got to hang out.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying, or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Alice is what matters. What's this do? Oh, I turned it off. It was cutting logs, and now it could never cut again. Oh, dear. It's okay, though. This is a very nice neighborhood here. Bird. We got tons of ammo, which is always a good sign. I know it's not easy, man. Where are you at, Stucky? Stucky, come at me, bro. Hey, Stucky. How's it going, Stucky? Oh, ow. Oh, dear. Alright. Success. Yeah, I kind of show you the cop-out way of doing that. Just save up all of your delicious... flashbang? Not flashbang. Whatever it's called, signal flare ammo. And it makes pretty simple work of our dear friend Stucky.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Oh, you will. You're not that far, you little wimp. Stucky. Yeah, he gets on talking about Nordic walking. I never knew what Nordic walking was until this game. I thought it was something they made up. It's like, Swedes, they're Nordic, right? Remedy us obviously has something they're talking about. Ugh. That's just frightening looking.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
Ugh. It's gross. That's what it is. Coffee. We're still on the search for coffee, if I remember correctly. We're always on the search for coffee. What am I saying? Coffee is a very vital, vital thing, a part of my life.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting, at least for a moment. The sane world reasserted itself.
Oh yeah, by the way, I don't promise getting all the coffee. I wish I could, but you know, it's pretty hard to do.
The cabin on Cauldron
Oops.
Lake?
I pressed it too early. Now we press it.
Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
No need to feel bad.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Well, that's just not good. I was gonna say, I don't have to feel too bad about Sucky being dead.
I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help.
Shut up, Alan. There's probably important stuff over here. Yep, there it is. I want it. Oh no. You guys, this is not the place. This is a house of coffee. Okay? I do not appreciate y'all trying to kill me while I get some coffee. Oh yeah, this is a quick guy. He's super fast. That's what makes him unique. Hey guys. There we go, y'all. Y'all feeling good? Oh, you're dead. Ow! Don't throw crap at me from across the level. That's just rude. Ow! Don't appreciate that. You jerk. That is really rude. I swear that they- Oh! More coffee. They hit a bunch right here at the end. See, I guess you're supposed to go right into the garage, but I mean, you just miss all of these collectibles outside, which is really annoying. Let's see, I don't think there's anything around the bridge side, though. Let's go take a look at the bridge. It's pretty nice looking. It's going to be like, no, you can't pass. Kind of cool to fight something on the bridge. Anything going to fight me on the bridge? No. No, I don't think there's anything over here either, though. Well, there's enemies, of course, but they're always fun to talk and chat with. But nothing here. Well, that was pointless. What am I saying? I don't need more walking. Alright, walking done. Oh man, there's a lot of people who I've killed tonight. I'm gonna weigh heavily on my consciousness. You guys gonna fight me on the bridge. Man. I guess these people have been engulfed. The godlight told us that these people have been. Whoa. These lines don't match up. Hey. That's not cool, man. You're not good, though. I heard you coming. Well, I guess we better get on with it. Oh man, I've just been recording for a straight 18 minutes. This is gonna be a long episode. Fuck. I'm sorry. You guys have been here for so long, you probably wish you had something else to do during your day. Instead of listening to me.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Nah. Ooh. I want to go to the Deer Fest. Sounds like there's a lot of fun.
Legendary Deer Fest Parade.
Yeah, Nordic walking. That's what it is. You have, like, two poles. I never knew that. Just thought it was some crazy, crazy thing that never existed in America. But it does. Ugh. Well, let's end this all with a phone call. I'll see you guys next time.
Great Bull Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen,
I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wade.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake. Not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Clown, they call the Sandman, tiptoes to my room every night, and just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper, go to sleep, everything is alright. I close my eyes, then I drift away into the magic night. I softly say a silent prayer, like